Hey, it's Rich, the Louisiana Hobby Guy. Today we're going to be configuring the Monport K40 with Lightburn, the Lightburn edition. And the reason why it needs to be configured with Lightburn is because you don't run a CO2 laser at 100% power. The companies that you see on YouTube that, the Eon and Trotec and the others, they have their machines regulated so that they do say 100% in the software, but that's not 100% on the hardware. They're regulated to 70% of the maximum rating of the CO2 tube. So today I'm going to show you how to set up the machine so that you too can regulate your K40, your K40 Monport Lightburn edition, to use only 70% of the rated wattage. So this way you don't burn out your tube prematurely and wind up having to replace a tube after a couple of months. It should last a couple of years. So let's jump over into the shop next door and let me show you how to get that done quick and easy. All right, so now that we're in the shop, here is the Monport K40. Down below I've got the 5200 chiller. So the first thing I'm going to do is turn that on and get that started. And I always use a quality chiller with any CO2. I did do a homemade hack in a video a while back using an ice maker, and that works just fine, but you have to monitor the temperature too much. So I like having the automated chiller down there, and that just makes life easier. So now let's just cover some of the parts. We've got the on-off switch right here. Got the ammeter, and these are the two things that we're going to be looking at today, and the emergency stop. The first thing you want to do is make sure that your emergency stop is not on by turning it to the right. Make sure that it's popped out. Second thing we'll do is turn on the laser, and you'll see that the lights now come on. And don't worry if it doesn't home. Some computers it'll home, others it will not. On this one it will not because my screen is off. So what I'll do is I will go ahead and put my fingerprint on the laser, and if we come over here to the screen, all I have to do is right click on devices like that to reconnect to the Monport, and the laser should home. It didn't in this case, so let's take a closer look. It says ready. So I'll hit home. There we go. And it's homing. And I probably have that setting turned off up in here. And I do. Auto home on startup. I'll just turn that back on. I don't know why I had that turned off, but it was turned off. So now that I've got this set up, if we open the door here, you can see I've got my piece of test wood in the right spot there. My ammeter is now on. And I'm going to turn the dial all the way to the zero position or minimum position on the left side, like that. So with everything on, with the job ready here, I'm going to come to the laser tab, frame it. And if we come back over here, you'll see it's in the right place. I'm going to close the door now to activate the safety switch. And now I'm going to start the job, and we're going to watch the ammeter. Okay, so now we've got the cut running in here. I'm going to turn the air assist on to blow out the flame. There we go. And we're going to come over here to the ammeter now. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to slowly start turning this up until I reach 17 to 18 milliamps on the meter. And now that is my 100% setting in Lightburn. We will never touch this dial again, except in the future to test it. And you can see that is max power, 17 milliamps is approximately between 17 and 18. You might even want to go 18, is about 70% of the tube's capacity. So that's all there is in setting this up. We can now stop the job in Lightburn. And we are finished. The laser is completely calibrated, and as you can see, it's gone all the way through the wood there. So that's about it. Remember to focus Your little focus gauge is included. Remember to focus your laser before you do this. Doesn't really matter, but it helps. So again, all you have to do is leave that ammeter dial exactly where it is. As you can see, I'm at about 75% power on this machine, and I will no longer touch that. I can now use Lightburn anywhere from 10% all the way up to 100% and not have to worry about overdriving the tube. All right, and that's it. That's how easy it is to regulate the laser power on the Monport K40 Lightburn Edition. Now, again, it is extremely important that you run this test, and you can save that file for future use. Maybe every month or every 2 months, if you use the machine quite a bit, run that file again, make a slight adjustment. This way, the settings in all of your files will never change. So if you create a file today that has a speed of, 1,000 millimeters a minute and a cut power of 50%, 6 months or a year from now, you will have the same exact results without having to change that file. And all you have to do is take a scrap piece of wood every month or two and run this exact test. Just open that file back up, run the same exact test, but you have to be sure that you don't touch that ammeter dial once you've run this test. Once you have that 17 or 18 milliamp set, some people say you can go as high as 20. I don't. I stick with 17 to 18, right in that area. Once you've got that number dialed in on the dial, on the ammeter, then you can run any program in Lightburn at 100% power, because you've used that variable power resistor that's coming from the power supply to control the amount of voltage going to the laser tube. And now you know that you will never overdrive that tube. I can tell you that I did service in the field for a while, and I've replaced a lot of tubes, and I had people that had, 100, 150 watt lasers that didn't do their research when they first got it. And, they watch these videos on YouTube and they say, 100%, I'm running this thing at 100% power, and bang, a month later, the tube is dead. A tube that should have lasted on a big laser like that, maybe 5,000 hours or something like that, 4,000 to 5,000 hours, a month later, it's dead. So when I get there and they say, well, I don't know why, this must be a crappy tube. And one of the ones that I worked on one time, it was a recce tube. And I said, no, you have one of the best, you have the best tube on the market. The problem is that you probably overdrove that tube running it at 100% power. And he said, yes, well, of course I did. That's what everybody on YouTube said to do. So, take everything with a grain of salt that you see on YouTube and do a little more research. You don't even have to believe my videos. These are the results that I get. And my oldest K40 is, 4 years old now? Actually, it's 5 years old, the one that I gave to a friend, a different one. And that machine is still going on the first tube. So, there's got to be a reason for that. And that's because I dialed in that power. And it doesn't matter if you have a regular K40 or the Monport. On the regular K40, the only difference is you'll have a different control panel, but you'll still have the power up and down buttons, usually up by 10, up by 1, up by 0.1, something like that. Just keep turning the power up until you reach that 18. Now that I think about it, you can't do that. You have to have a milliamp meter as well. There you go. Install the milliamp meter, then you can turn that power up until you reach the 17 or 18 milliamps. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I hope you learned something, and I hope you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed making it for you. So as always, I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.